Alright. Internet keeps flustering. This hand's fine. It's not super good, but we got a cantrip and we got all of our mana. I'm going to go ahead and play the Terramorphic first because we don't even want to go turn two Hexmage. And this will thin me a land. Really just dead to like a quest on turn one, but anything else and we should be okay. Core Duelist. I'll get a Plains. Wall you. Alright, we got six drops. Six drops are in the bag. He doesn't have a quest, he doesn't have any Memnites. Memnite's probably pretty bad against us since we have the Ratchet Bombs. He probably just left them out. What's he gonna get? Basilisk Collar. Sword. He is all in. So yeah. So I could get three here and discard one, but since he doesn't have counter magic, and I don't want to draw a hawk, but the chance of drawing a hawk is pretty low, and I also don't want to discard a land since I have these two six drops in my hand. Normally, you grab all your hawks and then you just pitch like your worst card in your hand, but I think since all of our cards are kind of necessary at this point, as long as we don't draw one of the last hawk or whatever, this ends up working out better for us. Of course, now that I say that, we will obviously draw the last hawk. Just the way things work. He's putting it into play via Stoneforge Mystic, so he's obviously got another one drop. Or not. Interesting. Ooh, that was a good one to draw. So yeah, we'll just play one hawk. Actually, I could play two hawks. If he hooks it up, I just get the chump block. I guess I waste his entire turn next turn if I do it now, but I have a million chump blockers for that guy. And I kind of want even to get some of the stuff in the yard. Plus, I get to start attacking. At the next turn, I don't even have a play other than the Doomblade and Squadron Hawk, so this is probably just better. Get the beats in. If that was like a, I don't know what else it could be, Sword of Vengeance or something, then I would probably have to keep Doomblade open. That's a little late. Just gonna equip. I'll throw a hawk in front of it, I think. Keep the wall around for one more turn. I don't really want to draw another land, so I'm going to... Oh, I guess I have Admonition Angel. I probably shouldn't have done that, but I will. I was trying to thin of lands, but it actually is just worse than leaving it for Admonition Angel. This game looks pretty good for us, though. Last game, we just lacked these six drops. We never drew them. This game, we have two of them. So, even though our hand was kind of slow. What is this? Argentum Armor. Alright, well, now I have to save my Doomblade, most likely. Because he can just Core Outfitter. And get us... I guess it doesn't do much. Alright, so that works. I get to attack. Day of Judgment. Or I could play Sun Titan, get back Wall. Probably better. He has to have Core Outfitter. Hook it on to guy. Maybe just wait two turns. Which means I attack with both these. He plays Core Outfitter. I get to Doomblade. If he doesn't play Core Outfitter, I get to Wrath. Seems better for me. Since I have 7th land in hand, I think it's reasonable to just sit back. Of course, Skyfisher. So he'll bounce a land with that. Maybe he'll bounce a Stoneforge Mystic, but I think it's still going to be land. Yeah. Play land, play Outfitter. Oh no, he's just going to put something into play. Okay, so our Wrath should be pretty good here. Obviously, chump block this Duelist. In that case, I think I can just Admonition Angel Argentum Armor and be fine. He only has Journey that can do anything about that. Yeah. Then I get to Chump Block, Doomblade, Sun Titan. I'm trying to think. Sun Titan even gets back a land, gets back a Marsh Flats, so that way I can Doomblade. Yeah, that seems good. Yes, I do. So unless he has a Journey to Nowhere in his hand, should be good. Because next turn I get to play Sun Titan, get Marsh Flats, remove two more things, and have Doomblade open. Probably even get all of his lands. We do take a ton off of Core Outfitter still. Because Core Duelist gets to attack twice and we get milled for a bunch. But that's a small price to pay. He has a Skyfisher. Okay. He might have a second Argentum Armor in his deck for this quest, but he'll probably get Stoneforge Mystic back, replay Stoneforge Mystic. He already played his land for the turn. Oh, he's going to bounce itself. He's just trying to get counters. Seems better to bounce the Mystic there. He gets another thing out of his deck. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe he's just trying to get it all for next turn. What does that do? Okay. Activated a Stoneforge Mystic with no mana. So he's going to bounce Stoneforge Mystic this time. Which is totally fine. This is at 3 counters. So if we draw a land here, we're super good. We're obviously going to chump block this thing. Inquisition. Okay, it doesn't... We can take the Stoneforge Mystic, but that's not even that good. So instead... Get back Marsh Flats. Yes, I would. Goodbye, quest. Yes, I would. Battle. Now I get to remove two things to instant speed on his turn via land and Doomblade. So even if he plays Journey here to get rid of the Angel, I at least time walk him basically. And he's at 6, which is also relevant. So here he's probably going to get Basilisk Collar to try to stay alive. Yep. He'll hook that onto a duelist. This Abomination Angel has been very good, by the way. Been impressed. If I had not punted against the blue-white player, it would have won that game. Sure. Alright, so we're going to let him attack. I'm going to get a swamp. We're going to remove one of these guys from the game. Yes. I'm going to Doomblade his core duelist. And then if I draw a land, he's dead. Or Gideon. What does Gideon do? Not much. Inquisition him. Make sure the coast is clear. He has to block. Glimhawks don't do a lot. They buy him some time, but he has to bounce stuff. If I attack and then play Grave Titan, he's just dead anyway, so I'm just going to go ahead and nuke this. He has to chump block. I guess he can hook up Sword of Vengeance plus Basilisk Collar, but he still has to chump block there. Here he's got to block the 2/6 drops, and I get a land back, Marsh Flats, move his Core Skyfisher from the game. Okay, so that was pretty sick. Sun Titan plus Admonition Angel, best buddies. So after that game, anything? Hexmage just still seem bad. I mean, not bad. They're good against the quest, but I think Revoke's just better since it hits his equipment too. And we still have two Hexmages in there. So yeah, we're just going to go to game 3.